Welcome back to another episode of Aliens vs Predator. Last episode we had just got Tequila to the medical wing, but unfortunately Wayland had caught on to us and diverted power from our area, so we couldn't use the medical apparatus to save Tequila. But luckily there was an apparatus to power up the cryo tube, so we can keep her in stasis until we can get to a medical wing and actually perform the surgery on her to get the thing out. So yeah, so now we got to try and find William Tani's PDA pad so we can call in the registered dropship to get us out of here, because our main ship was destroyed by the Predators, and guessing, I don't know how there must have been more dropships that must have come down to the thing, to the planet, because there was quite a lot of troops there. But I'm guessing most of the dropships were shot down, or they're just too far away to get to now. There's no way we can call them in, fortunately. So anyway, yeah, let's carry on with the marine campaign, but let's have a good look at the actual Predator Temple, because I actually really like the Predator Temples, because they're really well detailed and really cool. So yeah, see what happens. Just hope it lets me keep my weapons. I really hate it that it changes your weapons out. You shouldn't do that.
Thank you. obviously a driven individual. I can respect that. A seat at the table. You deserve that much at least. Come. I want you to learn why it is so many of your comrades have died. A dying billionaire embarks on a voyage of discovery to a frozen wasteland. Experimental technology stores his memories. He knows his chances are slim, but it is not the cancer in his lungs that will bring him to his end. Charles Bishop Whalen's final moments are lost to me. Unlike everything else, they cannot be recovered, but they continue to define my existence.
As our work here advances and the risks increase, Whalen expands the combat android's remit. They arrived as mere hardware, but now they appear to outrank most of my staff. How long before they start giving orders to me, too?
Private. Glad to meet you, finally. I've been monitoring your progress. I knew you'd make it this far. You're a survivor, like the hunters that once ruled this planet. Like the xenomorphs they stalk. Like me. It's just that I've had a lot more practice. I'll take that. Have you ever asked yourself where the Marines source their weapons? We're old friends, the Corps and I. In fact, you might say I own it. That means I own you. And when a corporate asset is no longer of use, I dispose of it. Deal with them.
Thank you.
Alice, I know. But these combat androids, they unnerve me unlike any xenomorph. On one hand so human, yet on the other, utterly dead in every respect.
I possess knowledge and experience spanning centuries, but I lack the single causal beat that defines me. In that instant, Charles Bishop Whalen saw them both for the first time. Two creatures, each of them perfect in their own way, each of them unimaginably valuable. At that moment, my ancestor, my predecessor, my template, he saw my future.
Aim for the head. It's the old. Have the data pad, sir. No complications. Yes. The live specimen is secure. Transmitting data pad contents. Now.
This has been a high-cost operation. Let us hope my predecessor's faith in it was justified. It's everything we'd hoped. Worth waiting centuries for. The coordinates to the Xenomorph homeworld.
Completed. Hope you've enjoyed it. Next part we'll do the alien campaign, and then obviously we'll do the Predator last. But yeah, it's quite an interesting story. It's a bit strange that the main character players doesn't talk, but usually that's sort of the case in most games. You know, it's not the protagonist. But yeah, it looks like Wayland actually got his data, finally found the Xenomorph homeworld. I mean, if you've watched the new Alien Covenant, it's obviously... Well, actually, it could be possible. I mean, we don't really know whether Android took those thousands of colonists and the Xenomorph embryos. Could have found a planet, decided to make a planet after species. Not too sure. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed the Marine campaign. It's definitely one of my favourite ones because it's a lot more easier to play as a Marine than as the Alien Predator, because really you don't really get any weapons, but obviously you are a weapon. But it's harder to wall crawl quite a bit, but I'll wait till I get to that bridge. But yeah, I'd also want to know if you want me to keep commenting on my videos, you know, doing a commentary. Because I don't mind doing both. I do prefer not to do a commentary, that way you get the sound and quality of the actual story clearly and having me talking over it. But if you want me to do a commentary, I can do. Because I would like to do a commentary, but the thing is, I struggled to think of things to talk about, because I would like to do a bit of research first before I actually, you know, do some commentary. You know, like, I could research some stuff on the alien campaign and the alien why they're on this planet and stuff like that. Yeah, stuff, you know, little details, you know, that sort of like, did you know sort of moments. But yeah, leave that in the comment section. Let me know what you think, and yeah, we'll probably do the entire campaign first. I mean, what I'll do is through the alien campaign, I will do some commentary and some facts, the aliens and the predators, and then at the end of the series, you can like comment saying, yeah, I like this, but you know, give me some feedback what you want me to change and stuff like that. But yeah, hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next campaign, which will be the Alien.